And Eli Kishimoto, among the fashion crowd, always commands a lot of respect. I have a lot of respect for them, and I'm not even important. But, like, you know, the power bloggers and everybody always have a lot of respect for Eli Kishimoto. So you always make an effort to come and support their work. So, and they also quite, you know, they have a following in the more mainstream and department stores and internationally. But I think what's important is that one of the brands who, like, the people who matter, all the opinion formers, I think they all have a really good opinion of Eli Kishimoto. Another thing I really like is the DJ. They're always with Jerry Boutier. Personally, one of my two favorite DJs, a dear friend, and Jerry is best known for his Boombox and Pony Step connection. So he comes out of, like, the most fashionable club that's of the decade, I'd say, in London. So, and again, it's an organic connection with Eli Kishimoto. So I think Eli Kishimoto are just a very organic London brand, a cosmopolitan London brand, and I just love them. So everything I'm wearing is Ashish, and I'm friends with Ashish. I've known him since his first collection. I have about 90% of what I wear is Ashish, even though I absolutely love Eli Kishimoto, but my personal style is Ashish. So that's one of the things I'm looking forward to. I saw Hannah Marshall today with Felder Felder, but I specifically went for Hannah Marshall. That's because there is a lot of buzz among the fashion brand about Hannah Marshall. I've seen some earlier work, and I think she's going to be one of those big creative designers to come out of London. So I went to do my research. What else? I like a young designer called Craig Lawrence, so I'm going to see that. It's just a static exhibition. What else? K to Z. I'm a great lover of K to Z, Cop on to Zai. That's Marianne Pevsky and Sasha Bizovsky. Again, another iconic London crazy brand that I absolutely love. So they've been able to set the tone and break boundaries since 1996. They are best known perhaps for that dress that Björk wore at the Oscars. Remember, like, the swan dress? And they just never stop being creative. So I just love that cutting edge creativity, and that's what London is about, and that's what
we need. Can I just ask you last one? How are you involved in the London Fashion Week, and why do you think it's important for London? Like, why is it so important for the people?
Why London Fashion Week is important for London? I'm just going to just do a little plug for myself here, because why it's important, I've written a whole book about it. And the reviewer is, you see, Jerry Boutier. The letters are a little bit too small, but I think London Fashion Week, there's different reasons why it's important for London, but obviously from an industry perspective, it's bringing in revenue. I think the fashion industry is bringing a lot of money into this country, and they've not been as recognized as the arts. I think the fuss around young British artists, the YBAs, and how much money went into that, the fashion never really got it. Now it's beginning to get that kind of support. And it's funny because it's part an industry, but it's part creativity. Young designers need support, so I think it's important for that. And it's important also for creativity, because London is the most creative capital in the world. If you think of New York, it's far more conservative. Paris is very bourgeois, you have the big brands there. Milan is the Italians and very commercial. London is the one where new ideas come from. And London brands like, you know, Eli Kishimoto, who are established, again, would lead the way, because they'll do a motorbike, or you wouldn't get that in other countries. So that's why London is really important. It's just the street heritage that presses over into the mainstream and start changing things. I mean, the cliche is the late Alexander McQueen, you know, when he did trousers halfway, you know, like, you could see the bomb, and then, you know, the hipsters came. London is full of that, and the new generations continue to do that. So, and guys have been around, like Eli Kishimoto, continue to reinvent itself.